God is saying, in order for me to help you save your life, help save what the world is trying to devour you, the world is trying to devour us, do not be cut off in her iniquity. For this is the time of the Lord's vengeance. You're in the time. This is the time. He shall recompense her. Babylon was a golden cup in the Lord's hand that made all the earth drunk. The nations drank her wine, therefore the nations are deranged. Babylon has suddenly fallen and been destroyed. Well for her, take balm for her pain. Perhaps she may be healed. We would have healed Babylon, but she is not healed. Forsake her and let us go, everyone to his own country. For her judgment reaches to heavens and is lifted up to the skies. The Lord has revealed our righteousness. Come and let us declare in Zion the work of the Lord our God. Verse 11. Make the arrows bright, gather the shields. The Lord has raised up the spirit of the kings of the Medes. I hope I'm saying that right. For his plan is against Babylon to destroy it. For his plan is against Babylon to destroy it. Who's Babylon? What's Babylon? Of the world, people of the world, following the world, because it is the vengeance of the Lord. He is saying, he is right here. He says, right here, right in verse six, chapter 51, flee from the midst of Babylon, like I was saying, and everyone save his life. Do not be cut off in her iniquity. Don't be the reason for somebody else's sin because they want to follow the world. Don't fall into that. Do not be cut off. Don't be cut off from the Lord because of someone else's iniquity, right? For this is the time of the Lord's vengeance. That's where he talks about again right here. For his plan is against Babylon to destroy it, because it is the vengeance of the Lord. The vengeance for his temple. Verse 12. Set up the standard on the walls of Babylon. Make the guard strong. Set up the watchmen. Prepare the ambushes. For the Lord has both devised and done what he spoke against the inhabitants of the Lord. He's speaking of it. He's saying, he's talking about it. He's saying, he's telling you, go ahead and do this. Go ahead and do as I'm saying. Because for the Lord has both devised and done. He has advised. He's advising you. He's done it. He'll do it again. What he spoke against the inhabitants of Babylon, it will happen again. He is going to do it again. Verse 13. O you who dwell by many waters, abundant in treasures, your end has come. The measure of your covetousness. Covetousness. What's covetousness? Covetousness. Let's define covetousness. Look, I already done looked it up. It's a noun that means an excessive and eager desire for something, especially wealth and possessions. It can also be defined as a painful awareness of another person's advantages or possessions and a desire to have them too. That's talking about an idol. If you're putting your desire for wealth, possessions, the measure of your covetousness, it will be measured. Verse 14, the Lord of hosts has sworn by himself, surely I will fill you with men as with locusts. Seen that word before. I want to define, what's locust mean? So it's a metaphor. Surely I will fill you with men as with locusts, as in a large edible pot of some plants and plea family, in particular the corbin beans, which is said to a locust. Yeah, so it's just like power, strong powers of flight. And they shall lift up a shout against you. Meaning very strong. It's gonna be very, very strong.